Well, David, the Champions Tour, those of us who saw the Milwaukee tournament, it seemed to be one of the more laid-back PGA Tour events. Laid-back kind of describes the Champions Tour, doesn't it? And won't that be kind of what fans here in Madison find out?
It is a perfect fit. Not just a laid-back, but also a real passion for the game in a quiet Midwestern kind of way. That's what you find out on the Champions Tour every single week. I think not only having that kind of a vibe, but also having the host, Steve Stricker, who fits all those qualities. This unbelievable venue, I mean, I've heard about some great college golf courses, sure. Ohio State, Yale, etc. This is terrific. So I think the Champions Tour players are going to love coming here. And I think the people as well are going to embrace the Champions Tour similarly to what they did at the GMO.
Now, those of us who watch your telecast know that, I mean, you interview the guys during the round. It's almost like there's a no-holds-barred on fun on the Champions Tour. Are there other things that you find on the Champions Tour that you just don't find on the regular tour?
Well, they understand, the Champions Tour players, that it's a different brand of golf. Guys on the PGA Tour are making their resumes. The Champions Tours are ambassadors of the game, so they'll let us talk to them between the ropes. I've talked to guys in the middle of a playoff, had guys tell me how they're going to hit a shot. I had Nick Price, after he lost a tournament, he hit a couple balls in the water. Flying home with him, he said, you know what? That's when you've got to come talk to us, when down times as well as up times.
Right.
So they get that the folks at home want to know what's going through their minds at all times, so they're open to any kind of suggestion or any kind of discussion we want to have. And it's terrific. Fun for us, fun for the viewers.
The other thing, for Milwaukee, you seem to struggle at times to get the name players. I turn on the TV every week and, you know, Bernhard Langer's playing, and a lot of the big name players from, you know, the previous generation of tour golfers. These guys don't take many weeks off, do they?
They rarely do, and that's the Champions Tour's one of the magical parts, is that they've scheduled it so that they're really no more than 2 weeks back to back.
Sure.
And so the players get a chance to go out for a couple weeks, spend time with their family, do other business, play on the PGA Tour, things of those along those lines. So you really do get the cream of the crop just about every single week, and you're going to get that even more so here, because wonderful area, but also Steve is such a drawing card, such a good guy and such a great player. I think players will turn out in force, spend time, see him out here.
Now, the 3M Championship up in Minneapolis, is that as close as the tour gets to right now to Madison? And what is the Upper Midwest drawing card to this tour?
Well, it's interesting because it's becoming a lot more Midwest-centric. You've got the 3M up in Minnesota. You've also got the Encompass over in Chicago. Mm-hmm. You've got in Iowa, you've got the Principal Charity Classic as well. Wow. Major championship cycle through as well. And it shows you that Midwesterners are so passionate about the game. On the Golf Channel, we get great viewership from these states, and also message boards and things along those lines. Mm-hmm. It's not just a passive kind of thing, it's interactive as well with the Midwestern viewers. So as much as we can be here, it's exciting for us, and having an event like this with the partnership between American Family Insurance and the University of Wisconsin, Steve Stricker and the Champions Tour, it's going to be a home run.
Well, we're looking forward to it. Dave, thanks a lot for your time.
My pleasure.